fact of the matter is, one of the biggest transitions you're going to have to make if you decide to continue on to collegiate wrestling is you're going to have to be able to wrestle out of the pot. So you're going to have to be able to fight for inside position. I watched you guys wrestle live, and a lot of you guys aren't even getting an inside position before you shoot. And some of you aren't even changing your feet. You're trying to shoot with your feet square. One of the first things we talked about today was making sure he does that little switcher step I call the scissors step. The problem is that you're trying to wrestle right here in a square stance. If I wrestle in a square stance, you give everything open to me. This leg, this leg, this leg, this leg, and his head, and his center body. So that's the defensive position. So if you guys are standing here like this, and you think this is your offensive position, nothing good is going to happen. Who's the best kid in here? Where's the little kid? Where's the kid in the second state? Right?
Second in state.
Yeah, right there. All right.
I got so, second in state.
Yeah, you don't count. You're a little kid. Okay. So look, show me how many shots you know on a square stand. Yeah. Well, you're the champ. You're the champ. Show us how many shots you know on a square stand. Best guy in the room, would you guys agree? Best guy in the room? Okay, how many moves you know? From a square stand. That's not a square stand. You just change it to a square stand. Exactly my point, so why in the hell are you guys standing there like this? If there's no move, no offensive move out of a square stand, why are all of you wrestling out of a square stand? Because you're adding a different move to it. If I have to change, now by the time I change, it's too much. Even if I want to do the little circle, swisher, whatever it is, any of this kind of stuff, it's an extra movement. So learn how to start wrestling in a power stand, okay? Second thing, a lot of you guys are reaching with the same arm that you have forward. Because Coach said, hey, watch these guys, you're really good, we struggle on our feet. Those are reasons why. You cannot be in a squared stand, and you can't reach with your front hand. You guys can reach with that front hand. If that's my lead hand, I'm in trouble. I cannot give up my lead leg and my lead hand at the same time. It just doesn't work. I have to go to the back hand. Then I can move into my dive. But I can't wrestle from here and think that good things are going to happen. And I sure can't do this, because a bunch of you actually did this. Well, now I've given you another chance. So common sense says the first thing I want to do is put him in what? I call it this, guys. I call it standard stance and my offensive stance is the defensive stance. Okay, this is for guys that just can't shoot and they like to stall and they only are going to score off you defensively. That's great. I love those kind of guys. Because those are the kind of guys that you can take down and take down again and again and again and embarrass them by the end of the second group. They just want to go home for their mind. Okay? So the first thing you have to do, if he's in a square stand or in a standard stand, is get him out of a power stand. Right here, we're both equal. We're both equal. My hands are on. Okay? If we're both equal. First thing I want to do is get his feet square. Okay? You guys are taking this shot and trying to make this front high drop right here. It's not going to work, guys. Even if I get a good square, it's tough if he's in a good standard stand. Because he can react to it. So the first thing I want to do is square his feet up, okay? A couple things with contact. You guys are reaching for contact. Don't reach for contact. Let your head make contact your back hand. Once he puts his hand on me, he engages me. Now I re-engage him with my other hand. I re-engage with my back hand, my power foot. Now I re-engage. Okay? A couple other things. Your hands are on top of his shoulder. Can't be here. My hands on my shoulder, that have nothing to break with. I have nothing to break it. Slight elbow. If he drops under me, changes his levels too much. I'm in trouble. So the first thing I want to do is try to square my thumbs. I like my thumbs right here. I like my thumbs right inside. That way I can feel everything that's coming. I like my thumbs up. This is an offensive position. But I have to move it. This stops the defense, okay? This is defense because my thumbs are down, gives me a chance to score. My offensive position comes over top. I call this a hook, I call this a claw. First thing I want to do is just square his feet up. And you guys just worked on it a minute ago. All it is this position right here. So all I'm going to do, give my partner, I'm engaging with my head, engaging with the hand. When he engages me in contact, I engage him in contact. slide the thumb. When I get ready to move, I'm going to go hook to a claw, and I'm going to circle, hook, shift my weight right here. Now I'm in the scissor step. Now I can go into my shots that we're going to go to in a minute. Okay? Just give your partner. Engage, front in, back in, circle, right here. That's all we're going to do. Nice and simple, right? All right, up two. One, two. Hustle.